What's going on, guys? Well, today we're going to talk about something I've been asked since I did my first video about the Action Movie Effects app for iOS, and that is, can you use the effects on a desktop editor such as iMovie or Final Cut or Premiere, and can you use it with footage shot on another camera? Now, it's not built into the app to be able to do this, but there is a workaround, which is kind of implied by just this comment that I got just yesterday asking about using a green or blue screen. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do. So first off, if you haven't seen the app, it's this really awesome app for basically making action-style special effects with your iPhone or iPod Touch video. Now, the only problem with it is that you have to use in-app video from it. So you can't import footage, and the effects can't be exported on their own. So, how can you get around that? Well, the first thing you can do is actually just shoot a blue screen or a green screen. If you don't happen to own one, don't worry about it. You can actually just Google, you know, chroma key green or chroma key blue or just bright green or bright blue like I did here and just shoot your computer screen. Now, once you've done that, you can basically just use the app normally and export it to your camera roll once you've put in the effect that you want. And then the next thing you're going to want to do is just go ahead and take those into iMovie or your editor of choice. So for this example, I'm going to use iMovie since that's the app that every single person that owns a Mac has. And this footage right here I actually shot on my Panasonic GF2, and it's just some basic footage of the parking garage here. And you can see here all our blue screen footage, and it's looking pretty good. So it looks actually like a fairly clean a blue screen just by shooting it on my computer monitor. So let's go ahead and insert this gunfire effect. So I'm just going to drag the clip down, drop it. Also, this is of note that if you're going to use this in iMovie, you need advanced features enabled so you can use the green or blue screen feature. I'm going to select blue screen, obviously. If you used a green one, select the green screen. And now let's go ahead and check it out and see how that looks. Alright, that's actually not that bad, especially considering that this isn't really what the app is intended to be used for. The only problem that you kind of run in at certain times is that there's, on certain effects, a camera shake built into it. So let's go ahead and put in this explosion, and I will show you exactly what I'm talking about. So if we watch this one all the way through, the beginning looks pretty good, but you can see that shake in it right there, so our debris is kind of moving around and it's not staying on course. So if you really wanted to plan out your shot and use this effect with some footage, you can actually just put actual camera shake into your original shots. So you see there, I added a little camera shake. Of course, it's still not going to line up exactly with the effect, but it'll at least look a little more natural than if you didn't have any shake at all. And of course, I didn't line up the timing right there at all, but you kind of get the idea of how you can make this a little more natural. Another trick you can do is actually cutting the footage off a lot sooner before the extreme part of the shake begins. So, like I said, it's not really perfect, so that's the big issue with it right there that you're going to have. But it's certainly passable, especially if you're making kind of a comedy-type film or something like that and aren't really looking for something too serious. So, that's it. That's how you do it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.